Thank you for joining us. Could you please introduce yourself, including your name and your current position?
My name is Nazanin Ansari, and I'm the editor of Kayhan London and Kayhan Life.
Firstly, I would like to ask how you found the event today. Was there anything significant that caught your attention?
I thought the quality of the speakers and the presenters was top-notch. Bob Blackman, who the MP who conducted the session, was very knowledgeable about Iran, obviously had worked very much on the Iran issue. Mr. Javaid Rehman from the UN made a very powerful presentation about the state of human rights in Iran. Also, Mr. Gharagozoloo, the representative from the International Organization for Human Rights, his presentation was most emotive and touching, and it was obviously that he had lived through 40 years of anguish, and he really delivered, communicated that well, and how much he represented what his anguish, how much that reflected what is going on in Iran right now.
What main actions can be taken to help counteract the human rights violation in Iran?
I think the main work that can be done to counteract human rights violations in Iran is, number one, for international organizations to publicize this, and also at the level of policymakers to make any engagement with the regime officials dependent upon their conduct of human rights policies inside the country. I think that is very important to have countries of the region, that might be difficult in the Middle East, but certainly at the international level, UN, Europe, to take to put human rights at the center of their policy towards Iran.
Why do you think the violation of human rights in Iran should matter to the West?
I think the conduct of human rights in each country is very important, and it's reflective of their conduct outside of their borders. Certainly from the moment we saw the Islamic Republic gain power in Iran, take a foothold, the abuse of human rights, executions, imprisonment of minorities, ethnic minorities, religious minorities definitely increased. And a regime that does not respect the human rights of its own people, how can the international community expect for it to respect the human rights of people outside of its borders? So it is not a surprise that 40 years after the Islamic Revolution, we see the people in Yemen, Syria, Iraq, Lebanon, all complaining about the conduct of the Islamic Republic in their countries.
Finally, do you think there's a need of these kind of discussion and events to take place in order to help stop human rights violation in Iran?
I think it is very helpful for meetings such as the one that the International Organization for Human Rights organized today, for this to be replicated and to be increased, because certainly we need more information, we need more dissemination of information, we need more civil society actors and activists participate in such sessions and to engage with one another and to understand that the rights of one man means the rights of every man.
Thank you so much for your time.